We have created a profile of the existing grade. On closer inspection of the profile, we can see blue vertical lines that are not in line with any stationing. These indicate the position of horizontal curves. We want to remember this when we are creating a proposed vertical alignment, because it can be challenging for drivers to deal with a horizontal and vertical transition at the same time. We want to make our road as safe and easy to navigate as possible. We also need to consider how steep the grade is in some areas. For example, in this area, we have a steep grade we need to consider. Knowing that trucks do not climb steep grades very quickly, we may need to place passing lanes in this area. With these things in mind, let's strike our alignment. Let's go to the Profile menu and select Profile Creation Tools. The command line is prompting us to select the profile in case there is more than one profile. Click on the profile to select it. The alignment is a proposed roadway. We can name it proposed roadway as well. Let's describe it as a two-lane rural road. The profile style is set to design profile, which is correct. We will accept the rest of the defaults, including the complete label set. We can edit any of these later if we wish. Click OK. Here is the profile layout toolbar that provides design tools. We will start by drawing tangents without curves. The command line prompts us to select a start point. Zoom in to the beginning of the project. We want to make sure that we snap to the very end of the line here, which is existing ground. That way we have a smooth transition from the existing roadway to the new roadway. To snap, we hold the Shift key and right-click, and then release the Shift key. A flyout menu with object snap choices appears. Select Endpoint. Then we need to zoom in to ensure that we snap to the endpoint of the line. Notice that there are small segments in here to snap to. These make it easy to select the wrong endpoint. Carefully, we click on the very end of the project. Now we are ready to strike an alignment. Here it looks like we have a horizontal curve, so let's make a straight transition through there. That brings us into a curve, but at some point, we'll need to transition through a horizontal curve. So a large radius curve here could be advantageous. Click here. We will continue to travel uphill with our alignment. As we go, we should think about the material being cut and material needing fill. Ideally, the cut and fill should be balanced as closely as possible. As we reach the end of the project, it is important again to snap to the existing roadway. Press Shift, right-click, release the Shift, and select Endpoint as we did at the beginning of the alignment. Zoom in to select the correct endpoint among the many possibilities in the area. Click on the end of the line, and then zoom out to see what Civil 3D has done. All of the points of vertical intersection and endpoints of the alignment have been labeled. We can use those as references for placing vertical curves. Here we need to go to the Highway Design Manual to verify the lengths of vertical curves that are required for this roadway. Then we can go to the Profile Layout Tools and select an option for putting in vertical curves. This time, let's use free vertical curves, PVI based. The command line prompts us to pick a point near a PVI or a curve to add a curve. So we'll select the first point of vertical intersection. Now we need to specify a curve length. Having looked in the design manual for this roadway, we can enter 1,000 feet. And Civil 3D puts in a vertical curve. At the next PVI, we will select it and enter a length of 5,000. This gives a nice long sweeping curve to help with balancing the cut and fills in this area. We can go through the rest of the project and put in vertical curves as needed. At the end, here we will create a vertical curve with a length of 5,000 again. Now we should zoom out and check that we have not created a vertical curve that goes beyond the project. Civil 3D should not allow this. Since the last curve has been specified, we can press enter. Zooming out, we can see that the beginning and ending of vertical curves have been labeled. Now we are ready to edit and adjust the alignment we have created. Now is also a good time to save. All of the information about this profile is in the tool space. We have a surface, the existing grade, and now we have an alignment. Expanding the alignment, we find our centerline alignment, which we called proposed roadway. Expanding the proposed roadway, we find the profiles. The profiles include the existing grade of the surface and the proposed roadway. Under Profile Views, we have the proposed roadway profile. The tool space is where we can keep track of all of the information contained within the profile view over here.